Extending a very warm welcome to you all, my dear children. Hope you are doing all your assignments. And if you are having any problems, feel free to ask your queries to your teachers. So now, today we will move forward and we will do the grammar part. In this part, we will first start with the first part of speech, that is noun. To begin the class with, we'll start the class with a beautiful thought that education is life. Now we must start with the noun. I hope you all know what a noun is. Noun is a name of a person, place, animal, thing, or even a feeling. We will try to understand this with some examples. As for example, person, Raghu, Vijay, Gandhi, etc. Place or thing, hotel, Taj Mahal, tab, and also animal or feeling, that is dogs, cats, and honesty, etc.
And now we should know about the various kinds of nouns. The kinds of nouns are common noun, proper noun, collective noun, material noun, abstract noun, and also countable and uncountable nouns.
Now children, we will deal with all the kinds of nouns separately. For example, to begin with, first we'll start with common noun. What do we understand by common noun? Common noun means anything or people in general. For example, table, chair, city, or men, women, child, television, computer, even the star, sun, earth. What are we trying to interpret here? Here we are trying to see that we are talking about the things in general purpose. We are not naming them. We have not given them any specific name. So we are telling that this is a common noun. Forward to the second type of noun, that is proper noun. What do we understand by the term proper? Proper means something specific. So a proper noun is a name given to a particular place or person or thing. For example, if we specify a person's name, that is Gandhi or Tagore, instantly we come to know that we are talking about some special person. Then if we give names to some all kinds of things, just as for example phone, it may be Samsung or your computer, it may be Intel. And even the name of places, for example, Bandra, Mumbai, and even Allahabad. Or any person talking in general, if we have given them a specific name, for example, Sumit, Satyam, etc. So we have given them a specific name. So a particular person or place or a thing is known as a proper noun. Now we move forward to the third kind of noun, that is collective noun. What do we mean by the term collective? Collective means a group or collection of nouns. That means when more than one thing are termed as, in common are termed as one. For example, Gandhi's or Ambani's. Or we can see the second example, school of fish. That means a collection of fish. Or bunch of keys. That means there are more than one keys in a bunch together. So we are calling them as bunch of keys. So when a specific name is given to a collection of nouns, or they are termed as one. My dear children, we will move forward now with abstract nouns.
what do we understand by the term abstract? Abstract means the things which we cannot see or touch. So abstract nouns are an intangible concept given to terms such as emotions, a feeling, or a quality. For example, liberty, freedom, godliness, honesty, charity, kindness, or truthfulness. These are the feelings or the emotions which we can express, but we do not see or touch them. Now, children, we will try to understand the concept of the material nouns. What are material nouns? Materials or substances from which things are made. For example, the chair on which you are sitting, that is made of wood. And also the water bottle that you use, that it may be made of plastic. So material nouns are those names given to these things from which these are made. For example, gold, silver, iron, aluminium, cotton, silk. Here one thing is to be remembered, children, that mostly all of the materials come under the uncountable nouns. They are uncountable. We do not count them. Children, nouns have been further divided into two categories that are countable and uncountable noun. As you can interpret from the term, that countable nouns are anything that can be counted in. For example, you are holding one pencil, there are two books in front of you, there are four copies on the table. So anything that can be counted is termed as countable. We will understand with some examples such as an apple, a table, a school, a man, three women, or four boys, two girls, like this. So these all are the terms that are used for the countable. Now, children, we will try to understand about the uncountable nouns. Anything that cannot be counted is termed as uncountable. For example, if a jar of sugar is kept in front of you and you are asked to count the number of particles of sugar present in that jar, you cannot count them. Or example, a bucket of water is kept in front of you and you cannot count the number of drops of water present in that bucket. Even in a field of wheat, you cannot count the number of grains of wheat. So these things are termed as uncountable nouns. My dear children, you have been awesome this class. I felt very nice teaching you all. Hope you all understood the concept well and what do we mean by the term noun and what are the kinds of nouns. So you will be given assignments related to this. You are supposed to do them and then submit your copies. Thank you so much. Have a nice day. God bless you all.